Hey guys, welcome to Gadgets 360. My name is Pranay and in this video, I'm going to be talking about iPhone 12, well, all four iPhone 12 models. And I'm going to be telling you what to expect from this because all of the specifications pretty much have been leaked multiple times. And now we can say with reasonable certainty what Apple has planned for us in the October 13th launch event. So that's correct. Apple has announced that the iPhone 12 series will be launching on October 13th. The India launch date is not yet clear. The India availability date, India pricing, all these things are not clear. They will all be clear on the night of October 13th. So around 10:30 p.m. or so, the Apple event will start. And after that, we'll just have to wait for a couple of hours before Apple announces the pricing for both US and India. So before all of that happens, let's talk about what to expect from the iPhone 12 series. Before watching this video, be sure to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so that you get notified when we publish new videos. And as always, if you like our work, be sure to hit the thumbs up button and share this video with your friends. Okay, so first things first, the iPhone 12 series. Why am I calling it a series and why am I not saying there are just two phones? It's because this time around, all the leakers are suggesting that there will be not one, not two, not three, but four iPhone 12 models. And I was quite surprised to see that myself because the number of iPhones has been steadily increasing over the years. In 2020, we've already had the iPhone SE. Let's not forget that one. And now it looks like we are going to have four more iPhones. So a total of five iPhones in 2020. That's what it's looking like. Now let's see if that's true. But for now, here's what the leaks are saying. One will be the iPhone 12 mini. The next one will be the iPhone 12. There'll be a third one called the iPhone 12 Pro. And there'll be a fourth iPhone called the iPhone 12 Pro Max. So that's quite the mouthful if you really have to say that name. But the important thing here is that the iPhone 12 mini is going to be slightly smaller than the other smartphones in terms of the size of the display and other things. And there are a bunch of common specifications in all of these devices. Now I'll get to that slowly, but first, let me quickly talk about what the pricing could be. Now, at the moment, Apple has not announced anything. Whatever I'm saying about the price of the iPhone 12 is just my own educated guesswork. So we'll see after October 13th how right or wrong I was. So if you ask me to guess right now, I would say that the iPhone 12 mini would probably launch for the base variant at around 65,000 rupees. The iPhone 12 could probably launch at around 75,000 rupees. And the iPhone 12 Pro, maybe 1,05,000, and the 12 Pro Max, I would probably say 1,15,000 or thereabouts. So these are all my guesses. Let's see, in 1 week, be back here. I will be talking about the iPhone 12 series after the launch is done. And in that video, I will look at how right or wrong I was. Then you guys can either call me Nostradamus or you can say that I was completely wrong and this guy doesn't know what he's talking about. But definitely, I'll see you back in about a week to talk about all of those things. Okay, so now let's move on and talk about the common specifications in all these four iPhones. Now first, the main thing here is the A14 Bionic processor, which is going to be present in all of these phones. Why do I know this with certainty? It's because this processor has already been launched on an iPad model before the iPhone even came along. So this year has been a really strange year due to the lockdown and other things that are going on, which you guys are very well aware of. And this is 1 year where the iPad gets the newest processor from Apple before the iPhone 12 series does. So that's what happened. And that's why we can say that the A14 Bionic, it is going to be in terms of performance, it's already going to be better than what we've seen in the A13. Apple has announced as much. We'll just have to wait and see how well it performs on the iPhone specifically. Now, the other thing here, which I'm not happy about actually, is the fact that all rumors are suggesting that there is going to be no headphone in the box and no charging adapter either. You still get a charging cable, but that adapter is going to be missing this time around. Now, Apple has already done this with the Apple Watch Series 6, where they've said that they've gotten rid of that charging adapter from the box. So while on the one hand, Apple's claim is that this is for the environment, it generates unnecessary e-waste, and most people who own Apple products already have an adapter and other things. At the same time, I think that's an essential accessory that most people would still need, and taking it out of the box and making them buy it separately if they need it, I'm not entirely sure if that's the right move. So I'm not going to say that I'm happy about it at all. As for the headphones, well, honestly, the headphones that you get with the iPhones are not that great, the ones that you get in the box. If they were shipping AirPods in the box, I would be really unhappy if they removed it. But they're not. They're shipping one half decent pair of headphones that I never use personally. So I don't care about this particular development that much. But you guys can tell me via the comments what you think about this. If Apple removes the charging adapter and the headphones from the box, would you be okay with it or would you have a problem with it? Let me know via the comments. Let's move on to other common specifications now. So apart from the processor and the accessories, there are some more things that are going to be common. One of these is the fact that all four iPhones are going to ship with OLED displays. There will be no LCD display model this time around. That's what all the leaks are claiming. Now, this is a good development, obviously. I really like OLED displays. It would be good to have it on all devices. And the leaks are also saying that all of these four iPhone 12 models will have Face ID, which is again a good thing. And what I've seen in the leaks is that they will all have a single front camera. Now, I'm not entirely sure how to feel about that. The single front camera on the iPhone 11 series performed pretty well. With the iPhone 12 series, we'll have to test and we'll see how it performs, what new improvements are there in that. And after that, we'll make more comments about that. Apart from this, you will also get iOS 14 on all these devices. And that's just good news because Apple has been really good with software updates for its smartphones. And I'm not going to sit here and complain at all about the fact that you get long-term software support for its iPhones. I am really, really happy about that. That's one thing that Apple has done really well over the years. Okay, so let's move on now to individual iPhone models and talk a bit about each. So the iPhone 12 mini is the first one that I want to talk about. So far, what we've seen based on the leaks is that the display size is going to be 5.4 inches for this device. Now, that's maybe slightly larger than what you get on the iPhone 7, which was at 4.7 inches and slightly smaller than the 7 Plus series. So that I keep talking about the iPhone 7 because this is the one I have here. It's my primary device. I've been using it for almost 4 years now. So a 5.4 inch iPhone 12 mini will be interesting. It kind of reminds me of that Samsung smartphone. So they had done a mini version of that, I think in the S10 series. So maybe that's the kind of look that we'll get with this device. But it'll be interesting to see whether they manage to give you good battery life on the smaller iPhone. Otherwise, it could be a really good, really compact, portable device for many people. So we'll just see how that goes. Apart from this, for this iPhone, we do know that it is going to get 5G support, which is a big thing for many people now. Those who are looking to keep their iPhones for multiple years, like me. So that's one thing that's definitely coming. And you will get 64GB, 128GB and 256GB, these three variants according to leaks. Now, again, I'm not very happy, if it's true, that is. I'm not very happy about the 64GB base variant because, oh man, it's 2020. 128GB should be the absolute minimum. It's not like you can expand the storage on these iPhones. So I would definitely have liked more storage in the base variant. Let's hope that this particular leak is completely wrong and when Apple launches this device, we get surprised and there's no 64GB variant. But I don't see it happening this year. Now, let's move on to the iPhone 12 itself. The specifications of this device are going to be quite similar to what we saw with the iPhone 12 mini, but this time around you'll probably get a 6.1 inch display. I really, really hope it's an OLED display. I really hope it's not an LCD display, but let's see. Based on the leaks, at least we are seeing that it could be an OLED panel. I'll be really happy if they make that switch. Apart from that, the 6.1 inch screen, as I told you, is pretty similar to what we've seen on the iPhone 11 and the iPhone XR. So you guys probably know what to expect from that. You will also get 5G support here and you will also get the same 64, 128 and 256GB storage that you are expecting with the iPhone 12 mini. So again, not too happy about that base variant, but otherwise not much to say here. So let's move on to the iPhone 12 Pro. Based on the leaks right now about the iPhone 12 Pro, it does seem like this is going to be a device that has three rear cameras. So the iPhone 12 and the 12 mini, those are expected to have dual rear cameras, whereas the iPhone 12 Pro is expected to have three rear cameras. And this is a device where you'll definitely get an OLED display. So that's nothing to worry about on that front. And apart from that, I think the iPhone 12 Pro Max is the one I want to talk about the most. So while the iPhone 12 mini, the iPhone 12 Pro, the iPhone 12, all these three iPhones are going to get 5G support for sure this time, the iPhone 12 Pro Max is rumored to be getting a faster kind of 5G. So it's called as a millimeter wave 5G. Now, this will give you some faster 5G speeds, I think, and that kind of makes it a little exciting. So I don't know immediately what impact it's going to have on people in India because there's no 5G support here. But if you are in one of those countries where there is 5G, you'll probably see a big difference in the speeds or whatever. The other phones are rumored to be using some sub 6 gigahertz 5G bands, whereas this one is using this millimeter wave 5G. Now, let's move on and talk about one more thing which is there in the iPhone 12 Pro and the iPhone 12 Pro Max, which is a LiDAR sensor. Now, a LiDAR sensor is very useful for things like portrait shots where you need a separation between the subject and the background. So for example, if you're looking at me, my background could easily be blurred via this sensor. It's more accurate, it's faster, that's what it adds. And apart from that, there are also multiple augmented reality related use cases. So Apple has gone big on AR for quite some time. You have an app called Measure on iOS 14 as well and 13 as well. So you can quickly just measure distances, measure how big your bed is, measure like the size of your smartphone and other things on this via augmented reality. And with that LiDAR sensor, it'll become faster and obviously more accurate. So that is another exciting thing to look forward to. Now, apart from these things, not that much is known about the new iPhones. The exact specifications, probably not known right now. But I do want to talk about what else Apple could launch at this event. I am pretty sure iPhones are launching in the October 13 event, but there could be something more. Now, if you look at the Apple invite closely for this event, you'll probably start to, you know, see a lot of patterns in that one. Now, I'm not one of those people who likes to, you know, overanalyze these invites and try to guess what could be there in the event. But let's just look at it quickly and see, make some theories, okay? Just for fun between us, all right? So the number one thing is you can see high speed. That could probably mean 5G support. It could mean that the A14 Bionic chip is going to blow all other chips out of the water or something. But the high speed reference is most likely going to be about 5G. Then the next thing you're seeing is a few concentric circles. Now, I could take this to mean a couple of things. One of these is, if you can see the HomePod in the background that I have here, if you look at the HomePod from the top and if you look at this concentric circles, it kind of looks like the HomePod. So could we really see a HomePod refresh? Let's see. I hope so. I really want that device to be updated. And then there's the other thing, right? Apple has been rumored to launch an AirTag device. Now, that's not the official name of this one yet because it's not been announced, but it's some kind of an accessory that helps you track nearby devices. So I think one use case, just an example that I'm giving you here, is you could probably put it on your suitcase, and if you forgot where your suitcase is, you could see quickly where it is by using this particular device. So not too many details are available about that, but if I were to guess, maybe one of these devices is being launched at the Apple event. But this is also where you guys come in. You can tell me via the comments what you feel, what will Apple launch during this event, apart from the iPhones itself, and how you feel about the iPhone 12 series based on what we've seen via leaks so far. What, according to you, is a good price for the iPhone 12 series? And finally, the biggest question is which iPhones will be discontinued this year? Now, I'm not too concerned about really, really old iPhones such as the iPhone 7, 8, etc. being discontinued. Each year that happens. But what I really want to know is, will Apple keep the iPhone XR in the Indian market after the iPhone 12 series launches? And will the XR get a price cut? Second thing is, I want to know if the iPhone 11 will still be around or will it be discontinued? Ideally, I would like the iPhone 11 to be around and hopefully they give it a price cut and bring it closer to 50,000, and the iPhone XR goes further down and is available at around 40,000. But this is not an ideal world and I don't think Apple is going to do that. My guess would be either the iPhone XR or the iPhone 11 gets discontinued, and whichever device is remaining in the market, that will sell at around 50,000 or thereabouts. That would be my best guess. Once again, after the iPhone event is concluded, I'll be back here to talk about all of these things. So in that video, we will find out, we will talk about how right or wrong I was. So definitely join me once more in about a week's time. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching, and for all things tech, log on to gadget360.com.